Aquitaine, we've got one more item for you when you get a chance. We'd like it to stir up your cryo tanks. In addition, I have a shaft and trunnion.
Okay.
For a look at the Comet Bennett if you need it.
Okay. Stand by.
RTCC, will you?
We got one machine on the RTCC and we got dual CPs downstairs.
Okay, I want another machine up in the RTCC and I want a bunch of guys capable of running D-logs down there.
Roger that.
What all this means...
me that.
There it is. I see it.
Oh. Houston, we're getting our first look at the service module now. One whole side of the spacecraft is missing.
Right by the high gain antenna, a whole panel is blown out. Right up to our heat shield.
Copy that, Aquarius.
Look like it got the engine bell, too. Can you see that?
That's 4 minutes. Standing by.
Odyssey, Houston, do you read?
This is Odyssey. It's good to see you again.
Size Apollo 12 and Apollo 11. Apollo 13's command module, after it was inspected, ended up in a warehouse. My thoughts are that the accident of Apollo 13 was the best thing that could happen to NASA. People were getting very complacent. And so when 13 occurred, at the time that it occurred, because it could have been a complete disaster, which would have probably ruined the whole space program, it was the best thing that could have happened. Because it brought out the ingenuity, the leadership, and the teamwork that the NASA Control Center had, along with the crew that could actually comply with and execute the things that we got back up. The spacecraft of an almost certain catastrophe to a successful recovery. So I'm very proud of 13. Even though I didn't land on the moon, that was a disappointment for me. But then, you know, a lot of people landed on the moon. So so why should I? And if 13 was a very successful flight, I wouldn't be sitting here today to talk about it.